Now that we familiarized ourselves with the concept of neural networks, let's try to actually do machine learning with it. Now, the starting point of any machine learning task is to describe the problem that you're going to solve and define how you are going to quantify the performance of your algorithm. Or put differently, you need to define a loss function or an error function that you want to minimize. Now, in this video, we briefly summarize the choices you should make when working on regression and classification problems with neural networks. So the setting is that we are provided with this data set of measurements of data points, and we want to do something useful with it. And in regression and classification problem, we also have targets associated with it. But the point is, we have this data, we want to do something useful with it. And so we're going to design these neural networks that map these inputs to some output. And we can make a very complex design over here. That's up to you, be creative with it. But now we're going to focus on the outputs and optimizing, or actually training, such neural networks. We're going to focus on how to find these W's. So the general steps is define the number of outputs. This is basically given by the problem that you're going to solve, multi-class regression, classification or regression. So that defines the number of outputs. We also need to define an output activation function. I'm going to say in the next slide how we are going to choose the output activation functions. But all of this is really motivated by what kind of loss function we're going to minimize. Now, in this video, we're going to use a probabilistic interpretation of the network outputs in order to make decisions on these choices that we need to make. And these choices depend on the problem that you're working on, right? So now let's first consider the regression problem. So the setting is we have all these input points. So each input is a d-dimensional vector, and we want to map them to a corresponding target. And this corresponding target can take on any value on the real line. So now again, we resort to this probabilistic interpretation. So we have this true model that we want to recover that maps every x to a particular target t, but we have measurement noise, so we have uncertainty to take into account. So instead of making just one point prediction, we consider uncertainty in our predictions with these assumed target distributions. And so far we've been modeling these target distributions via Gaussian, so via a normal distribution. So the probability for a given target, given my input parameters, is parameterized by this mean. So this is the model that we want to recover, and there's some uncertainty on my predictions because I know my measurements aren't perfect. So that's described by this variance or inverse precision. But essentially we're making a prediction. So this y, that's the model that we're going to recover, and that model's really the mean of my predictions. And now in this neural network setting, this thing is precisely the thing that we're going to model with a neural network. Okay, so that's the problem, that's the overall strategy. And then the set, so then we're building a neural network that maps a single, a multi-dimensional input, so a d-dimensional input, to a single target. So that also means that I need one single output unit, which is given by my, so that's my final output activation, and I need to make a choice on what activation function I should apply to my final output activation. And since my targets are real valued, so they can take on any value on the real line, maybe I do not want to apply any activation function because, well, this activation of the output is already some number somewhere on the real line. So when we talk about regression, we usually do not apply any activation function to my output. Okay, so that defines our neural network. And then now, since we consider this in a probabilistic setting, we assume these target distributions. And then, of course, we want to maximize the likelihood, which corresponds to minimizing the negative log likelihood. So the error function that I want to minimize, such that I get an optimal model, an optimal neural network, is given by the negative log likelihood. Okay, and now we've seen this thing before, right? So we take the log of this normal distribution, essentially, and that gives me this quadratic term. And these are factors that do not contribute to my error as a function of W, right? So equivalently, we can minimize this sum of squared errors. Now let's take a look at the case of binary classification. So we have these input vectors, again, d-dimensional, but now my targets can only take on the values 0 or 1. And again, we adopt this probabilistic viewpoint on things. So we are going to say that my outputs, so my model, this is my neural network, so this is my neural network, that it models the probability of my target value taking, my target taken on the value 1. So again, we assume a target distribution which we want to model, and we're now modeling the Bernoulli distribution essentially. So my model spits out the probability for class 1, and that also implicitly gives me the probability for the other class. And then we can use these labels T to have this selection mechanism over here, right? So this is essentially a Bernoulli distribution, which gives me the probability for class 1 versus the other class. Okay, so then if I have to decide my output layer, how many neurons to put there, how many units, so we're really assuming a single target, which represents my the probability for class 1. So my neural network only needs one single output unit, so here denoted with A out, and we need to apply some activation function to it. Now, what would this activation function be? Now, the targets are binary, and the targets represent probabilities. So the outputs, my model spits out a value between 0 and 1, or that's what it should do. And that's why we're going to rely on the sigmoid activation function, because my model should represent the probability for the target being 1, and it should take on values somewhere on the range 0 to 1. Okay, so that motivates why we should use the logistic sigmoid. Now again, because we adopt this probabilistic approach to modeling, the natural choice to quantify how well my probabilistic model performs is really to take a look at the likelihood, right? The likelihood that my probabilistic model actually describes the data, or the other way around, that my data is described by such a probabilistic model. So we take a look, we want to maximize the likelihood, which corresponds to minimizing the negative log likelihood. And for the logistic sigmoid case, the log of my probabilistic models boils down to the cross entropy loss. So I want to minimize the sum over all my data points, the target TN times the log of my model plus 1 minus, so that's really the target for the other class, the log of 1 minus y xn. So this is my model. Okay, so when we're doing binary classification with neural networks, then my output is a single output, which is activated via the logistic sigmoid. And as loss function, we're going to minimize the cross entropy loss. All right, and then of course, we can also consider classification with K classes. So my input is again a d-dimensional vector, but now my targets, now my target is also a vector. So for each data point n, I have a target that looks like this. So tn2, tnk. Where each of these targets for each class, so for each data point n, I have k of such targets, which take on the value 0 or 1. And this was what we call the one-hot encoding of my class, right? So with a 1 hot encoding, only the target for my kth class takes on the value 1, and the rest is 0. So this is a one hot encoding of the kth class. So the one hot encoding really encodes these true probabilities, right? So if it represents the kth class, and the probability for all the other classes is 0, but it's 1 for that particular class. And now we want to recover such probability vectors, that so we want to really predict for each input x, the corresponding class probabilities. So we want to sort of model this target distribution, and this target distribution is then a generalized Bernoulli distribution. So let me write that out. So it's really the product of all probabilities for each class, but selected via this one hot encoding, right? So if I'm considering the Kate class, then only the Kate model is active, right? So that gives me the probability for class K. So that's what we're trying to recover. So this probability distribution that we can test for every class K, we can check what the probability is for that class. So that's essentially given in this form, where each YK represents the probability for that class, and the particular distribution that you see over here is typically referred to as the generalized Bernoulli distribution. Okay, so this means that now I have K targets, right? I have K of these probabilities that I want to predict. So this means if I want to design my neural networks, I should design it in such a way that it has K output units. And these output units represent the probabilities, and they're obtained by applying some activation function to my output activations. So now we're considering we want to predict probabilities. So that means that the sum over all my probabilities should equal 1, right? So this is what I want. I want the sum over all my classes. So the probability for class K given my input X, which is modeled via my neural network. I want this sum to sum up to 1. And this is ensured by the softmax activation function. So we saw before that this is the generalization of the logistic sigmoid, right? With multi-class classification problems, we can always formulate our probabilities in the context in the form of such a softmax function. Okay, so that really describes my overall model architecture. I want to predict K output units, and I want to use the softmax activation function to really obtain my final probabilities from the output activations. And now the corresponding error that we want to minimize is, of course, again going to be the negative log likelihood of my probability distribution. And that in the softmax case, again, it gives me the cross entropy loss. So I'm going to sum over all data points. So from n is 1 to n. And then I'm going to sum over all my classes, the true target, tnk, times the log of my prediction for that particular class. So this is the cross entropy loss. This is the cross entropy loss associated with the k-dimensional generalized Bernoulli distribution. So this is the loss that we're going to minimize. Okay, this then summarizes what we did, right? So we considered regression and we considered classification, and now we want to design neural networks and define the loss functions that we want to minimize. Now in the regression case, in all cases we approach this from a probabilistic viewpoint. Now in the regression case, we assume a Gaussian target distribution because there's uncertainty in my predictions. And then I let my neural network make a prediction for the mean of these distributions. And so that actually also tells us, because this mean can take on any value on the real axis, that my output activations, I have one output activation, and it's activated with the identity activation function. And these ingredients together then tell me if I want to maximize the likelihood associated with this target distribution, I'm going to minimize the least squared error. Now for binary classification, we assumed a Bernoulli target distribution. So we really, my neural network makes a prediction for the probability for class 1. And then the probability for both classes is given by this at Bernoulli target distribution. And this also tells me that we want to work with, as output activation function, we want to work with the logistic sigmoid. So these ingredients together tell me that my loss that I want to minimize is going to be the cross entropy loss. And likewise, in the multidimensional case, we assume a generalized Bernoulli distribution for K classes, and my neural networks makes a prediction for each of these classes. And to ensure that my output predictions are indeed can indeed be interpreted as probabilities, we need to apply a softmax function on all these output predictions. And then again, we want to maximize the likelihood, and this eventually boils down to minimizing the cross entropy loss.